international outrage over the collision of a Chinese ship with the Philippine Navy's resupply vessel in the Ayungin Shoal. The Philippines denounced China for committing a blatant violation, but China insists on blaming the Philippines. Pia Gutierrez has tonight's top story.
The Philippine government is taking seriously the recent confrontation in the West Philippine Sea. After illegal and dangerous maneuvers by Chinese vessels led to collisions with Philippine ships on a resupply mission to the BRP Sierra Madre at the Ayungin Shoal. On Monday, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. called for a command conference in Malacanang with the country's highest security officials to discuss China's latest aggression, which, according to Defense Secretary Gilberto Teodoro Jr., is a blatant violation of international law.
China has no legal right or authority to conduct law enforcement operations in our territorial waters and in our exclusive economic zone. We are taking this incident seriously at the highest levels of government.
President Marcos Jr. has directed the Philippine Coast Guard to conduct an investigation on the incident, which the Coast Guard says it is looking to complete within 5 days.
We will focus on determining the extent of damage or damages done or incurred by the vessels involved. But at this point, it is very, very clear that the two incidents are violations of collision regulations, the very regulation we Coast Guards are expected to enforce. So we find it unfortunate or ironic that a fellow Coast Guard will violate the law where they themselves are supposed to enforce.
But Beijing blames the Philippine vessels for the collisions, saying that they went headlong towards Renai Zhao's lagoon and bumped dangerously with Chinese Coast Guard ships and the Chinese fishing vessels there. They also claimed that their actions were professional and restrained.
The Chinese government is deliberately obfuscating the truth. Chinese Coast Guard and maritime militia vessels, in blatant violation of international law, harassed and intentionally hit Unaiza May 2 and Philippine Coast Guard vessel BRP Cabra. This is a serious escalation of the illegal activities conducted by the Chinese government in the West Philippine Sea in complete disregard of any norm or convention of international law.
The Philippine government, meanwhile, has filed another diplomatic protest against China and summoned China's envoy, Ambassador Wang Shilian, over the incident. But as the ambassador was out of town, the Chinese embassy sent their deputy chief of mission in his place instead.
Ayungin Shoal is part of our exclusive economic zone and continental shelf, and we have sovereign rights and jurisdiction over it. Therefore, as we did in the past, we intend to clearly convey our position that we have every right under UNCLOS to carry out our legitimate activities in our maritime zones and that we do not accept any form of interference.
This is the third time Wang was summoned by the DFA and the 55th time the Philippines filed a diplomatic protest against China in 2023 alone. Meanwhile, the incident has provoked the condemnation of the diplomatic community, with several countries, including the European Union, expressing support for the Philippines. In a statement, the U.S. State Department said that the second Thomas or Ayungin Shoal is well within the Philippine Exclusive Economic Zone and that there is no legal basis for any entitlement by China to maritime zones in the area. Washington also reaffirmed that the Mutual Defense Treaty extends to armed attacks on Philippine armed forces, public vessels and aircraft, including those of its Coast Guard anywhere in the South China Sea.